the 19th of March, one lightweight kickboxing world champion, Raheem Ersel, defends his belt against second-ranked Mustafa Haida. Riding a 16-bout win streak, Ersel is a force to be reckoned with. He became the inaugural one lightweight kickboxing world champion when he took out kickboxing legend Nicky Holtzkin. The match began one of the most heated rivalries in ONE history.
Jab two from Ersel, left hook from Holtzkin. Great start from both these men. Nice right hand catches the jaw of Holtzkin. Turning hook from Nicky. Doesn't let the right hand go here. Good inside leg kick from Raheem Ersel. Ersel wants to get airborne with a knee. Such a big unit. Overhand right, left hook, right hand again, a high knee. Here's the combination, here's the aggression.
Nice inside leg kick. He's used that inside leg kick really well in this second round.
If you're watching around the world, folks, how do you score it after three? It's a close one. Remember, the winner of the round gets 10 points. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. There are no draws in ONE Super Series. Good stiff jab between the eyes. Jab to the body, uppercut. Raheem Ersel comes forward, there's the jumping knee, and another knee. Holtzkin pirouettes, gets out of danger. Knees again from Ersel. It's all knees now, flying knees from the Dutchman. Flying Dutchman. And he continued the flow, goes to the liver. There's an uppercut, then the knee, another high knee, almost shaved him. Rocks the head back with the left hand. Here comes Raheem Ersel. Oh, there's the knee. Smack bang on the chin.
Raheem Ersel mixing that low kick very well. Also going to the head and body, the way he's mixing in the combinations.
Catch Raheem Ersel.
Beautifully done. Let's check out how he landed this beautifully timed knee. Set it up with the right hand. There comes the left. You can see Nicky trying to cover up, but the knee just splits the guard and drops the natural. Look at how he does it. You see the guard is nice and tight, but the knee finds its way through and drops the natural. Look at that beautiful work from Raheem Ersel. You called it, Michael Cervello. You were seeing something. Call it your shot with the knee knockdown. And then the knee found a hole.
Holtzkin's ready. Holtzkin's ready to go down. But is there enough time left in the round? Here comes Raheem Ersel, the knees again. Holtzkin's a shaken man.
Side, you can see it. The speed of Holtzkin's just not there. And he touches him there with the knee.
30 seconds left in the final round.
Every time Holtzkin tries to throw that speed.
Has Holtzkin got one big top thumper? He tries with the left.
The contest came down to the wire, but Ersel did enough to get the victory and claim the crown. After the bout, controversy rose over the low blow in the second round.
Well, the knee didn't look to clip the groin. It may have been the top of the shin that actually connected.
The knee actually connected to the stomach or a little bit lower into the solar plexus.
Many fans believed the blow was clean and that it should have counted as a knockdown.
Nicky didn't protest. I think he felt it.
Well, Raheem felt it, but Nicky didn't protest. You're right.
As a result, a rematch between Ersel and Holtzkin was arranged to put the matter to rest. This time, Ersel made sure his dominance was unquestionable.
Look at the high kicks to the knees here of Raheem Ersel.
These guys have got hundreds of beautiful combinations landed there. He goes to the midsection with a jab. Loses his hand, just cutting through. That constant pressure coming from Ersel.
Raheem Ersel has on fire in the fourth round. High knee again. Front right punches, then goes to the body.
In the middle chunk of this round, it was all Ersel skipping in, landing beautiful body-body combinations into the clinch.
Holtzkin's been in it a long time. Made his pro kickboxing debut in 2002.
This is where he was having success, just that constant pressure.
Body shot there off the lead hand from Raheem Ersel. Kick from Holtzkin, switch up roundhouse. Roundhouse lead leg from Ersel, outside leg kick. The champion in white. Good jab. It took there from Holtzkin. boxing.
He follows it up with boom, jab, inside low kick, flying knee, and comes right back in with that low kick.
Had one career, wins over Bruce, that was voted up, Shahid Al-Haj and Jerry Mix. Inside Dyke from the champion, cuts off the circle, holds him 7-4 over the last 17 years against Dutch opponents. 46 knockouts in 92 wins for Holtzkin. Inside leg from Ursel. Jump turning back kick. There's the Taekwondo coming into play. Taekwondo, a Korean martial art known for its kicking arsenal. Rekken Ursel, a phenomenal performance against Nicky, the natural Holtzkin.
With a career-defining performance, Ursel put an end to his rivalry with Holtzkin. But a new challenge has presented itself in the form of heavy-handed Mustafa Haida. The second-ranked contender made an explosive debut in one Super Series when he took on 8-time Muay Thai and kickboxing world champion Daniel Dawson. The bout was an exhibition of kickboxing at the highest level.
There's a left hand down the tube from Mustafa Haida, the southpaw stance on Haida, which means Dawson wants to keep his lead foot on the outside of Haida's lead foot to engage that rock right hand. Dawson, the first man ever to win world titles in boxing, kickboxing, and Muay Thai.
You know, letting that reach advantage get the better of him. He's staying inside, utilizing those hooks to the body, going up top when he can.
Dawson taking his time, edging forward ever so slightly. Got to cover up that right side of his face, protect against the power hand of Haida. Dawson, nice little counter. There's the left hook, goes to the body. Beautiful work from Rocco. Haida against the ropes, bobbing and weaving. Good head movement from the Moroccan.
Very good head movement. Both these guys got very agile heads, good eyes. Consistently moving, keeping their head off of the center line, never giving their opponent stationary time.
Little gut munching knee, belly button through the back there from Dawson. Haida reset center of the ring. 140 remains, third and final round. Body shot from Haida didn't connect for him. Dawson, who's been in some absolute wars throughout his career. The likes of Amir Shafapur and John Wayne Parr, who he fought on several occasions. Fakes the right hand there, Dawson. Comes forward with a front kick. Falls short with a left hand. Dawson airborne! No knockdown, no. Says referee Onari. Just off balance there, Mustafa Haida. Dawson had a good idea, though, for the flying knee. Haida, beautiful left hand. Dawson's got to cover the right jaw. Got to glue that glove to the side of his head here, Dawson. Step through knee from Haida. Dawson may have been. Mustafa Haida, a tremendous victory here in Shanghai. My word, this man packed the power tonight.
Haida's ferocious knockout cemented him as one of the most exciting kickboxers in one championship. On the 19th of March, he looks to land his incredible power on the reigning king of the one lightweight kickboxing division, Rekken Ursel. But Ursel has beaten the very best in kickboxing, and it will take more than a puncher's chance to dethrone him.